Sigiatum Paulus Ioannis Baptisabi Baptisto Penitentia Portum Dicens et Vim qui venturus est Sanctus Ips ut quaerat hoc est in Iesu. His habitus baptizati sunt in nomine Domini Iesu. Et cum in pro suissa iris Ioannis Paulus veritis Sanctus Peters. Et loque bantur linguis et propit lac. Erant data omnes meriti in origine progressus autus anonum conducere ad abatto per tres mensas disputans ad persuadans de renude. Alleluia, alleluia, confitem he domino con le honoris quali in seculum est abitus. Laudate domino con les gentes et colorate e con omnes populi. Bonium contra nota est sudum vos misericordia eis. Et veritas domino. Amen.
Spirit hovers over, he rests over the waters. The Spirit of God blows
over the waters of creation. It's not that creation has to gussy itself up and get ready for the Spirit to come. The Spirit blows where he wills. The Spirit moves as he wills. And the very point of Pentecost is that though the disciples were indeed preparing, and we should be preparing, they're also utterly surprised and shocked at what comes, right? They haven't been given the script. And so it should be with us, that yes, we prepare in the life of Christian faith. We live this life of Pentecost Saturday, waiting for the coming of the Lord in his fullness in the Holy Spirit. But we also recognize that he blows where he wills, and that he has come among us, whether it be in tongues of fire on the apostles, or their ability to speak in tongues, or in the various gifts he gives out to the church in every age. What are the gifts that he gives you and I in this age? Well, they flow from our baptism. They flow from the life of charity. They flow and are manifested at those times where we're able to do more than we could have ever found within our own hearts. We rise beyond what anyone could have ever expected us to do. Sometimes that's because they have a low opinion of us, but sometimes, and often, it's because the Spirit is just so generous and enables us to triumph in difficult circumstances that we live waiting on him and we live in cooperation with his prompting and inspiration. Sometimes we think of the gifts of the Holy Spirit as icing on the cake, that, oh, you know, I have faith, I've gone through catechism, I've received my sacraments, and oh, you know, and I'll live the virtues, you know, I'll try to be temperate and prudent and chaste, and I'll try to have faith in God, and I'll try to hope, and I'll try to love others. And then, oh, the idea of the gifts of the Holy Spirit, the idea that we have to kind of be passive and the Holy Spirit act through us, well, that just seems to be extra. But St. Thomas Aquinas will say, the gifts of the Holy Spirit are essential for salvation. And you might say, well, how fair is that? The gifts come at the Spirit's prompting, and I can't gin them up myself. Well, how can I be graded on it? How can that be on the final exam? In this way, that there is so much in your life and mine, I'm sure in your own life you can put it far better than I can imagine. But there are so many times in our life, right, where we have to be able to take a step back and follow the Spirit's lead. We have to be ready to shelve our own expectation of how the day is going to go and see what God has in store. We have to be ready to see how God draws a greater patience out of us than we would have been capable of, a greater devotion out of us than we would have been capable of, a greater love out of us than we would have been capable of on our own. Christianity is not a self-help religion. We help one another, and we seek to grow in the virtues and to grow in the full stature of Christ we're called to, but we live on this vigil of Pentecost. We live waiting for the prompting of the Spirit. And the good news is that to the degree that we abide in charity, he abides in our hearts. Do you not know, says St. Paul, that you are temples of the Holy Spirit? And so it is for us, learning to walk forward in confidence, stumbling at times, I'm sure, if you're anything like me, but also seeing those ways that we surprise even ourselves because of the one who dwells in us and brings all things to completion on his terms, not ours. Dominus Domini.